Second, I don't, is anyone, any declaration of interest?
I think I should have kept us on the, on the form of the report. I've got a daughter who's part of the 14 that's referred to in, using her,
I just think it'll be in tonight, so I'm going to be in the council. that would be that the campus activity that is an annual activity in terms of preparation of the national register would take a different form at the much higher level, so that it would be much more targeted towards where matches come and the data is transferred. Because effectively, the core register would be data matched for information is held in the register. So where we've run a test run on that, so what's the capture in this report, and how successful it will be. Where the difference is that there will be a movement of people that won't be clearly matched. And so because we're not going to do a model, so there'll be a whole kind of like mail out in terms of information, we don't need to door to door, and can see where it's actually targeted.
Thank you. Just to add on to that, is proposed that the Cabinet Office intend on launching a national campaign which is probably likely to be included in relation to awareness around RER. There will be a local campaign as well, and one of the things that we look to do is to target those specific areas where we know that the take up is low, which means a little bit more to encourage greater registration as well. So this exercise has enabled a more intelligent approach to be adopted in terms of identifying those key areas and the wards where we need to and where we can, in conjunction with the national campaign, we will endeavour to try and ensure that the events registration and the lead to registration is also far more of it.
On page 19, the third paragraph down, it does come back to how I concerned that many roads have been reliant on other people by registering them and haven't taken on board the impact that's might have on their credit rating. And I can explain to you that that is if you're not registered as a on the electoral roll, you can't apply for credit. I was wondering if as part of the information campaign, rather than simply relying on written material and knocking on doors, we could use some of the funding to have an information campaign on local radio. 7 Waves Radio, for instance, or the local radio society, and emphasise the fact that it can affect your ability to use your source finance if you're not on the electoral roll.
Yeah, a couple of points. I mean, it's sounding quite rosy to be thought, but if you actually read the on page 17 recommendations, at the best estimates, that's still 10% of people who may possibly find themselves excluded. So, as I'm reading, we can celebrate the fact that you know we're in a good position now, but 10% of people being excluded from what our business is, which is democracy, I think is something to you know, really be worried about if we have to not to be complacent. So I hope it isn't a sort of you know celebrating that we are in a good place compared to the national figure. I'm really interested in maximising every single election, no matter who people vote for. I think it's part of what we do. It's our reason for being, if you like, as elected members, is people that take part in the democratic process. So I think it is given, you know, should be given the emphasis and certainly highlighted at the cabinet level for the emphasis. Just a bit on the Merseyside, Merseyside, etc. I mean, there's a good example where we can share the cost because the message in Liverpool and Seth and everywhere else is exactly the same message, isn't it? So surely, you know, those sort of campaigns will be on a Merseyside basis, if not a national basis. And the other issue I raised briefly, whilst we talk about walls of deprivation, it should be maybe not walls of deprivation, walls, the signature should be areas of deprivation, because as we all know, in some of the most affluent areas, there are pockets of deprivation all around this world. Yeah, but all I'm saying is that you know, concentration should be on those postal districts where those registrations go rather than simply wards. Because, you know, I'm a part of my ward where there's deprivation, chief by jowl with some of the richest people on the border, you know. So the reality is it's not just about wards. And I have got some reassurance from the chair about the sentiments. share last week about that assessment building study. But I think it is a good example of what we can do with scrutiny, particularly when we come to the policy paper later on, that we know things are coming. We knew this was coming, so we did a piece of work before it's arrived on our doorstep. I think that should be that in the future, that the end of the strike, if you like, sort of getting members up to speed with something that's coming around the corner. Gardeners will say, oh my God, isn't this awful where they arrive. So I would say congratulations to the team and thanks for being there, people to talk about.
You are known to, I know you are known to. I think that's all. report, if doing your matching exercise as part of the individual electoral registration, one could look at all the systems within the council. So, no, I wasn't using it in any kind of sort of underhand way. It was simply to indicate that quite a high number of people who come into one-stop shops will be on one of the council systems somewhere, because it's an IT exercise, this as much as anything else, or the exercise that we undertook in when we did it in August 2013, was very much looking at the difference, because I understand the different IT systems that we have within the various departments within the council. So it was in that context that we used it, not in any other.
Members of the committee to request that cabinet consider the reports and also add one recommendation. Committee thanks the other members and officers for their work in preparing the reports. So, second this word.
Second is chair.
Okay. One on news?
Three.
Any extensions? One against? Okay, thanks.
No.
The general report? Scrutiny review guidance. Given the increase in the number of testing industries and those engaged in screening reviews, this guidance has been developed by officers to support consistency in good practice. Just wonder if anyone has any comments or questions regarding this.
Highlighted two exceptions related to two exceptions at that.
two other issues I would just like to highlight to members. As a team, we produced another paper, Statistical Dependence, to support this paper. And it tends to be around the scene, but that's the reason I made a certain point to say. So we would agree with that. We know that we can get that to you tomorrow. And this is very much produced on the basis of the document which needs to suit the needs. So we would welcome your input and feedback on it. Is it something more certain to step forward? The second point I'd like to highlight is that the revised website of the council's awards, we will be providing copies of all the forms on a contact basis. You'll be able to download those forms from the website. We originally intended to email them out to members, but we were a bit concerned about the volume of email traffic in the results. So we've got another.
What was that?
It's a statistical dependence.